Hey there, my name is Andy O'Neill, and in this co-build tip video, I'm going to show you how to use a filter to enable you to schedule your scenario to run every X times. For example, if you want your scenario to run daily, but you only want it to process every 3 days, I'm going to show you how to build a filter to do that. So we're over here in Make, and the first thing we have here is we have an increment function module. Now the increment function just basically counts. And generally you would use that in a scenario to count the number of files or the number of things, but we can actually tell it to reset after a cycle, after a scenario run, or never. And in this case, we never want this to reset because we want it to continually count and keep track of how many times this is run. So I just ran this and right now we're at number 21. I'm going to show you how to reset this. I'm going to go here and I'm going to set after one scenario run. I'm going to run that module. So now we're at one and now I'm going to change it back to never. Okay. So what's going to happen? Now this doesn't have to be your trigger. It just needs to be in front of your filter. In this example, we're actually going to run it every 3 times. So this filter is going to keep your scenario from running on the first time or the second time, but then it's going to let it run on the third time over and over and over again. And you can do this with a different interval. If you want to run every 5 days or 17 days or 22 days, you can do that. In this example, I'm just using 3 as our interval for when this will run. And then the idea here, the use case I'm presenting is this would run every day, but it would only process every 3 days. So I hope that distinction makes sense there. All right, so we're going to do some math here. You do not need this in your scenario. This is just me illustrating what's happening. So in our math equation, we're going to put a 3 in there because we want this to run every 3 times. And then here's our filter. The way this is going to work, we have a format number. So we have nested formulas here. The inside formula is format number. So we've taken our increment count from our increment function module, and we're dividing it by 3. Again, if you want this to run at a different interval, that's where you would put that different number in. So we're going to divide it by 3, and then we want it to have 1 decimal point, and we want it to have a period. So that is what that function is doing. And then this outer function is converting that number into a string. What that means is it's going to be text. And then our filter is going to look for any result that ends with 0. So we only want every third result, which means it's going to end in a 0.0. So that's why we're looking for text that ends in a 0. And I'm going to show you how this works. And then over here, I've just added that formula again, just so we can see the full formula and end result. The only thing you really need is the increment function, and you need this filter. So I've just added some extra information just to show how it works. All right, so I'm going to run this once. And you can see our first number here is 1. So when we take 1 divided by 3, we get 0.33 into infinity. Now, our filter did not let this pass because our value did not end in 0.0. It ended in 0.3. because this is going to format this with 1 decimal point. So that was 1 run. Let's run this again. And you can see our value ended with 0.6. Still did not end with 0.0. So that was 2 runs. And let's run this a 3rd time. And you can see our filter passed. And so our expression here is 1. So we took 3 divided by 3 equals 1. So our number that was calculated is 1.0. So that number ended in a 0, so it let it pass the filter. So that was 3 times. So let's run this 3 more times. So there's 1. It did not pass. This is 2. And this is 3. Okay. And it did pass. So our number was 2.0. So looking at our filter, our calculation here would be 2.0 as text ends with 0. So that would pass our filter. So we'll run this a few more times and I'll show you. So here's 1, 2, and 3 passed our filter. 1, 2, 3, and it passed our filter. So this will work for any interval. And the difference here is when you set up your filter, this 3 right here is what I'm using. If you want this to run every 5 days or every 12 days or every 17 days, you would put that number there. And so this is just going to run and it's going to do that math, and it's only going to pass when it is a even increment of 17, for example, and that it runs only when equals a whole number. That is how you schedule a scenario to run every X number of times. In this case, we ran it 3 times. And I hope this video was valuable. If so, hit that like button. It encourages me and tells YouTube the video was valuable. Consider subscribing. We'll see you next time.